With us now on the line is Mufti Ismaeel Bassa from the Jamiatul Ulama KZN, and we also work very closely with Mufti Ibrahim Desai. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to you, to Maulana, and the listeners of Channel Islam International.
Mufti Sahab, firstly, before we even ask how you're doing this morning, our condolences go out to you. We know you work very closely with Mufti Ibrahim Desai. Mufti Sahab, just to give very, very high recommendations about yourself to you, to the family as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for one and all. Indeed, the world is mourning at the death of Mufti Ibrahim Desai. How are you doing this morning, Mufti Sahab?
Yeah, Maulana, as you can understand, the sadness and the loss that is felt by one and all, especially the ulama at the Jamiat, especially students, cannot be explained. Alhamdulillah, with the fadl of Allah, we had a very close relationship with Mufti Sahab, rahmatullahi alayhi. Hazrat Mufti Sahab was a great inspirational alim and scholar for everyone. As the saying goes, that when an alim passes away, the death of an alim is like the death of the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not take away knowledge by taking away knowledge in itself, but by taking away the ulama that carry the knowledge of deen. And Hazrat Mufti Ibrahim Sahab rahmatullahi alayh was a mountain of knowledge. For this great knowledge, great faqahat and understanding of knowledge. There are many people that study deen, and there are people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with the understanding of deen. And this understanding is a great bounty, as Allah ta'ala and His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated. And whenever we had interactions with Hazrat Mufti Ibrahim Sahab, rahmatullahi alayhi, he was very open, very honest, very sincere, and he gave his best advice. Whenever you sought mashwara from him, consultation from him, he was very sincere, and he was very open. If you look at the biography and the history of Mufti Ibrahim Sahab, Mufti Sahab studied Quran at the Miyak Farm Institute. Then Mufti Sahab studied his alim course in Davel for 7 years. Then he studied 2 years the Iftar course under Mufti Ahmed Khanpuri, and then he studied 1 year under Hazrat Mufti Mahmud Sahab, and then he came to South Africa. He taught in the different funoon and fields of Islamic science. He taught 10 years at the Isitingo Reach Madrasa Darlum. Then he also taught 10 years at Camperdown, and then he moved permanently to Durban, where he established his Darul Ifta, and where many of the ulama in Durban were fortunate to have Mufti Sahab at their doorstep. They would be in and out, constantly in contact with Mufti Sahab. And Mufti Sahab served in many positions at the Jamiat. Here, many details about Mufti Sahab and his academic contribution to the deen. But I will try and focus on Mufti Sahab's role at the Jamiat. We looked, and Mufti Sahab served the Jamiat for almost or close to 30 years. In 1993, Mufti Ibrahim Sahab was appointed as the Mufti of the Jamiat. At that time, the formal fatwa department of the Jamiat was established. And this appointment was under Hazrat Maulana Yunus Patel Sahab rahmatullahi alayhi and Maulana Umarji rahmatullahi alayhi. They appointed Mufti Sahab to that position, and up till Mufti Sahab's demise, Mufti Sahab was heading the fatwa department. Mufti Sahab was also on the Iftar committee of the Jamiat, which is the official fatwa wing of the Jamiat. Mufti Sahab was an executive member of the Jamiat for years. Mufti Sahab was the head of the fatwa department. And in fact, Mufti Sahab was consulted on various issues and on various aspects, whether it was the moon issue, whether it was a social matter, whether it was a business matter, a business dispute, whether it was some fatwa angle or fatwa ruling. Mufti Sahab was always there to give his advice. And whenever you messaged him, whenever you contacted him, he was readily available to assist and he was readily available to give his time. One thing about Mufti Saab is that Mufti Saab used to be very active in the judicial committees of the Jamia. So the judicial committee is basically where marital matters are handled, and where grounds are found, and a marriage is annulled. Mufti Saab would come with his students, all his students, to the Jamiat office, and Mufti Saab would then engage with the parties, and the students would sit as observers to those hearings. Many people would see Mufti Saab's fatawa, but alhamdulillah, we had the opportunity to see on a weekly basis Mufti Saab engaging with the parties and trying to resolve the issues and the matters. And one outstanding quality of Mufti Saab is that he was very quick in picking up the issues, very quick in trying to resolve the issues. So meetings that would usually take 2 hours to 3 hours or even longer than that, Mufti Saab would then wrap that meeting up in half an hour or even lesser than that time. Mufti Saab was very, very active in the Jamiat, and Mufti Saab, mashallah, had great skills that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed him with. And one quality you would hear across the board is Mufti Saab was a very humble person. So whether you were his student or whether you were someone else, alim or non-alim, he would deal with you as if he was your friend. At times, ulama would have to remind themselves, or at the back of your mind, you would have to think that, you know what, this is my ustad, this is my teacher, and this is my senior. Because the way and the manner he would discuss with you and he would talk with you, you would sometimes forget that this is actually a senior of yours or this is actually a teacher of yours. A very humble person indeed. On a one-to-one basis, Mufti Saab would write his fatawa, he would do his tahqiq and research. And then at times he would send his research to us at the fatwa department for our opinion. He would seek our opinion and he would want to know our views on his own tahqiq and his own research. What a humbling individual, such a senior person. But this was his level of humility. And then, you know, he would also be clear that, you know what, be open with me. You know, you can critique it as far as possible, as long as it's within the framework of a fiqhi discussion, within the fiqhi framework. And, you know, that would go on, and he would not be offended at all, as long as it was within the framework of a fiqhi discussion. So if you wanted to challenge his view, if you wanted to challenge his position, he was open regarding it, and he would invite you to come forward and say, you know what, tell me what is the issue, what is the objection you have, and he would engage with his students in that way, he would engage with ulama in that way, and he would also engage with other people that were not his students in a similar way. If you had to confide in him, Mufti Saab would keep the utmost confidentiality between you and him, and the love and compassion that he showed it cannot be explained to anyone and everyone, whether it was the beggar on the street or whether it was anyone else. Mufti Saab had a lot of love and muhabbat and compassion. Even when he would address the people that would contact him, his students or non-students, he would always start, my beloved so-and-so, oh dear respected so-and-so, and he could hear that love and compassion in his voice. And with his relationship with the Jamiat, he always invited us to some seminar, some discussion, etc. And he would always recognize, you know, the former students that would come for those discussions, for those seminars, etc. And he would take their names and he would appreciate them coming. I mean, you know, an ustad generally, the student is always seeking the ustad. And you know, you may have an ustad that has hundreds of students, thousands of students, and sometimes they forget your name, so on and so forth. Mufti Saab would not forget. He would know the person by face, by name, and he would also keep contact with that person on a weekly basis, on a ongoing basis. So that is Mufti Saab's qualities in brief, just to explain a little bit. I mean, books can be, an entire book can be written on Mufti Saab's character and Mufti Saab's dealing with the community. The community has benefited greatly from Mufti Saab. I mean, just by listening to the Q&As or the CII Q&As that were aired on a weekly basis, you can gauge from there what an ocean of knowledge this Ummah has lost. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant Mufti Saab the highest of stages in Jannah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for Mufti Saab's family. I mean, this Mufti Saab's family, Appa, she has lost her father, she has lost her mother, and she has lost her husband in a space of 5 weeks, all at once. She has lost these members of her family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for her, make it easy for Mufti Saab's children, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make whatever he has done for us as a Muslim Ummah a great means of sadaqah, a jariyah for him.